Hello everyone, in this video, we are going to work on data-wrangling. This book, data-wrangling, has three parts. One is import, one is tidy, and one is transform. So we are going to talk about data-wrangling through tibbles, data import, and tidy data. And then we will talk about data transformations through relational data, strings, factors, days, and times. Let's go ahead and talk about chapter 10, tibbles. So in this chapter, we'll explore the tibble package. And you can just use library of tidyverse to load that tibble package. So first of all, I start a new R script. And let's define our data frame. So suppose I call my data frame as data.frame. And it has two variables. One is named as ABC. It has value 1. And the other is named as XYZ. And it only has one value, A. And you can run this line, so your df data frame is defined, and you can run df, and you can see that you have two variables, and each variable has one observed value. So as you know, you can actually type df $abc to view the observations under abc variable. And you can also check what you are going to get if you use df $x. You get value A, and it showed you levels A. So it kind of like XYZ can be recognized using X only. So I get exactly the same answer when I use X and when I use XYZ. So this is data frame. You can also use squared brackets. And you can type the variable names in the quotation mark after the comma. And then you should get A, same as when you use $XYZ or $X. Sometimes it can be confusing because when you type the wrong variable names, it seems like it still gives you the answer. And now let's create a tibble. First of all, you want to install a package called tidyverse. So that's the popular collection of packages. And if you have installed it before, you don't need to run that line. You just use library tidyverse. And you run that line. Let's create a table first. So you can create a table and you can name it df2. And you can do the same thing without using data.frame. Now you are creating a table and you're still assigning abc equals 1, xyz equals a. And you can run that. You can now run your tibble and you get the output here. So it's very clear it is a tibble 1 times 2. And you have two variables. One is a number, one is a character. If I want to subset this data, if I want to see what observations I have under abc variable, I can still use $abc. And I'm getting 1. If I do XYZ, I'm getting value A, like the character A. If I do $X, I will get a null output, and the warning message is like unknown because there is not a column named as X. So I guess that this is a good thing about using tibble, because you will not get confusing answers when you type the variable names incorrectly. especially if you have a variable name that is XYZ and another variable name that is XST, right? So when you use $X, you may still get an output for the data frame, but that may not be the right variable that you are looking for. And using a tibble, you actually get rid of that possible mistake. Another thing we can talk about is that when you print the data, if you have a data frame, you will get rid of overwhelming the console. For example, a dataset that we have used before is called Iris, and you can run that dataset, you can see the output is all over the place in the console. You can see it printed out everything in the console. But if I change that data iris into a tibble, I just use a function called as underline tibble, and then I put iris in there. And now I want to run that line. Pay attention to the console now. See here, I only get a tibble with the first 10 lines printed out and with 4 variables, the variables that can fit into this window here. 5 variables. So that's a good thing about tibble. When you print it out, you are not seeing all the outputs overwhelming the console. Now let's practice creating more tibbles. So I call it df3 and I type the function tibble, and I'm going to type the variables one at a time. So I let x equals the numbers from 1 to 5, and I let y equals 1, and I let z equals x to the power of 2 and plus y. So those are the 3 variables I created, and I can run that and I can print out my df3, and you can see this df3 is a tibble which is 5 by 3. If I only want to look at the x variable, I can use df3$x and run this, and you can see I get the list of x values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can also do that by using double squared brackets, and I let it to be my first element, and then I can run that. I still get the same output as using $x. Let's move to another tibble example. Think about a flight dataset. Just type NYC flights 13 and use 2 colons, the flights colons and the dataset name. If you run that line, you're going to get the only first 10 rows of the data and with the columns that can fit into the window. So you can see there are so many rows are not printing out, so many columns that are not printing out. You think 10 rows are enough, but you want to see more variables, then you may add a pipe, and you can specify that information by using the print function. So you can type n equals 10, that means 10 rows. And then you can specify the width. If you let the width equals infinity, that means you want to print out all the columns in the data. Another way to check on it is to type the same thing, NYC flights 13 colons flights, and then you can use the pipe, and then you can view the data set. As you know, view function is to open that data in a new window. So I can run that line, and all the data sets will be seen here, all the columns and all the rows. You can see the full data set by using a new window here. Before I save this document, I'm going to make some notes here. So this one is create a data frame. And those are for checking specific variables. And this one is for create a new tibble. And these are called subset the tibbles. One is for check on the data frame. And this option as that tibble is to change a dataset from a data frame to a tibble. And this is another example of creating a tibble. And these are examples of subsetting the tibble. And this is for change the printout of a tibble dataset. So if you have a tibble, you want to change how many observations you are seeing, then you can set up in this way. And this is for open a new window for the tibble. Now I'm saving the R code to my folder, and this coding file will be uploaded to GitHub.